2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA. The 2K Sports pregame show.
And in our matchup tonight, we'll see Omaha going up against Los Angeles. And guys, for Los Angeles, they've been on a tremendous run, and we're deep enough into the season now to know that it's no mirage. These guys definitely for real. So right around the halfway mark, we're starting to see MVP candidates emerge. Shaq, you won that honor back in 2000, putting up tremendous numbers.
Yeah, I had a career high in averages, points, and assists, and that was the year of my first championship, Bernie.
Shaq, do you think you should have won more than one MVP?
I sure did. I got robbed twice.
I think overall in your career, you should have had four. But in 2000, when I was working as a student analyst watching you, man, that was a great Laker team.
I appreciate you very much.
Pleasure to know you. Honored to be sitting here next to you. Isn't this guy the greatest?
Man, it's Shaq Mendes.
And in the locker room, each guy has been going over and through his own routine to get ready. But once they take the floor, they're one single unit. Welcome, sports fans. Thanks for joining us. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we'll have David Aldridge filling us in from the sideline. With 10 games left, let's see how the playoff race is shaping up out west. You take a look at Los Angeles, holding on to second spot in the conference, a great season for them so far. And checking out Omaha, sitting there four spots below.
You know, for Los Angeles, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
They do have the pieces in place for a title run, but the competition in the playoffs will be stiff.
And a look at the starters for Omaha. The Cobra out there with Smooth. Then there's Shake and Bake, and it's Alvarez in at the four. And for Los Angeles, we've got the Professor. The Bulldozer is out there with Williams. Then there's Christie, and it's Lewis in at the two spot. Some guys check the league standings every day. Others try to avoid it. What was your approach when you played?
Hey, I didn't look at them much because we were a team that was struggling, Kevin. We were just trying to find our way to being competitive back in the early 80s with the Pacers. So I never got to the point where we were a team that was looking at the standings daily. And I avoided the papers pretty much throughout my career just because to me was a bit of a waste of energy and time. I had more things to focus on than where we were in the standings and what people might be saying and writing about.
And here's Los Angeles. Pass to Williams. He kicks to Lewis. The Bulldozer passes to Lewis. Five on the clock. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. From deep three-point range. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. We're about 1 minute into the first. Stolen by Lewis. And he lobs it up toward the rim. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. Stolen away. Pushing it up. Here's the Bulldozer. And they pick up two.
Really nice job to convert the putback opportunity there. I mean, he stayed with that play from start to finish. That's something we say about him a lot.
Here's Smooth. Six on the shot clock. Pass to Holmes. Omaha needs to get off a shot here. There's the triple. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. This, their first chance to take a look at Omaha this season.
And they usually came out on top when these two teams faced off last year. No surprise, they're the better team.
Yeah, and very tough to beat when they're playing up to their capabilities. That's why they're one of the top teams in the league.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
Here's the Cobra. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against Portland.
And it was never all about himself. He came away with a lot of assists in that game and just kind of kept everybody in the mix.
And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Christie kicks to Lewis. To the paint. It's intercepted. And they're moving it up. Over in the corner, Marshall. Another miss, and they've really hit a rough patch here.
Boy, they are frigid right now. I mean, failing to connect on their first four attempts.
Passes it to the bulldozer. Here's the professor. What a tremendous game he played against Minnesota. Just two to shoot. Here's the bulldozer. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. The bulldozer's got five now.
And creating a little separation here, gaining some confidence.
Yeah, you get the sense that they're going to start stretching this lead out a little bit.
So timeout called here, the first for Omaha. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
And, you know, you have to feel terrible about how that thing turned out. I mean, the game was really going about as expected until they just gave up that huge surge there late in the game, totally lost momentum, and ended up losing that.
Switch here. Tavares has checked in.
And here are the numbers for the professor. Coming off a terrific season. First in scoring. First in shooting percentage. And of course, he's got a nose for the ball. He ranked in the top 10 in steals last season.
And his unmatchable instincts for scoring the basketball. That's what made him number one last year. You can't stop him. And you can't even really contain him. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. And there's the pass to Christie. He feeds it to Williams. And it's Williams finishing it off.
When you find yourself up double digits in the first quarter, you know you're doing something right.
Well, they're doing everything right. How about that? I mean, this could turn into a blowout very quickly.
Here's Tavares. Here's the Cobra. Williams with the block. Here's the professor. Pass to Sharp. Here's the professor. The three. And again, Los Angeles with the triple. And taking a quick look here, guys, at the hustle stats for Los Angeles.
Boy, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And also defensively, they've been able to cause some turnovers tonight. And that also builds confidence and gives you momentum.
Here's Lewis. Omaha making their last shot. Passes to the professor. Lewis outside. There's the three. And the three ball is good.
And the D has gotten a little bit laxed here defending the triple.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark.
I can't figure out, guys, what's going on with him this quarter. I mean, he hasn't gotten one shot to drop.
Left side, Williams. Lewis on the wing. Launches it. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
And, Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
It took him a while, but he finally gets one to fall.
There's 31 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Williams, that's good.
D defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
And here is Omaha now after the basket by Los Angeles. From deep, it's hauled in by Los Angeles. They're coming off that win against Minnesota.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game, great adjustments on the offensive end.
Well, it's really hard to stop them when they're in a groove offensively, and they were in a comfort zone all game long in that one.
The first quarter concludes in a double-digit lead on the scoreboard. Los Angeles leads by 17. We've got more in store for you right after this. And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And taking a look at Los Angeles' performance here, what have they been doing or not doing?
Well, the offense is clicking, and they seem to have seized the momentum here early on.
Yeah, you know, I agree. No warm-up needed. They came in on fire and have already built a nice lead.
Omaha trails by 17. Christie is out there with Williams. Then it's Bonnet. And there's Mr. Moves. And it's Sharp in at the five, roaming the paint. Here's the quick. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Here's Alvarez. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
And that's a huge play. I mean, they need more like it because second chance points are going to be key in this game.
Mm-hmm, probably so. That's usually a crucial element to any comeback.
Yeah, and if you look at it, had they been converting those second chances all along instead of waiting until now, who knows?
So for Omaha right now, the quick is out there with the Cobra. And it's Alvarez in at the center position. The pass to McKnight. Baseline J, that one goes in. The Quick's got his first points in this one.
A lot of players keep track of their stats, their own team stats. But Clark, how much do guys pay attention to stats in game?
I have no idea. I mean, I know stat sheets are given to the coaches during the timeouts throughout the game, but I don't think players in general are able to monitor their numbers. Now, there are exceptions to every rule. I imagine every team may have a player or two that can chart his numbers during a game, but the vast majority are too occupied with playing the game to keep up with the stats.
And they're looking up at the scoreboard, too, aren't they? Because they give individual stats up on the board.
Oh, man. Yeah, I tell you that, and then watching replays is one of my pet peeves with players. I mean, they should just focus on playing the game instead of always looking up to see if they fouled him.
Omaha calls timeout.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
And I think this timeout, guys, is where you draw up some plays that are guaranteed to create some high percentage shots.
To Los Angeles. Now, while we've got a moment now to see this year's three-point contest and how it's shaping up, let's take a look at some of the top candidates emerging as we see here some players who are likely to make the final cut.
Not too shabby of shooters on this list, Kevin. You gotta love the advancement and really the evolution of the three-point shot in today's game.
And you look at the Cobra. He's going to need to leapfrog quite a few great shooters if he's going to be a part of the three-point festivities on All-Star Weekend. But, you know, maybe he can do it.
I mean, anything's possible, especially if he has a few big games from beyond the arc before All-Star Weekend. That'd give him a nice bump in the voting.
And we'll keep you posted as we find out more and as we get closer to the three-point contest once we have our final list of official contestants.
Yeah, it's going to be very competitive. That's the one thing we all know. We got an incredible group of long-distance shooters in this league right now.
And here is Los Angeles now. Omaha knocking down that triple moments ago. Connects from three-point range.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets three, you fire three of your own. Boom.
Here's Smooth. His last outing, he had 8 points.
and he misses his first shot of the game. Now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter of basketball. For three, Bonner, and again Los Angeles with the triples.
Give them credit. Offensively, they've been the more efficient team.
Well, you know, it's been all high percentage shot for them so far. I mean, just the kind of execution you want in the first half.
Here's the Cobra. He's got six. Pass to Marshall. Down to five on the shot clock. A shot, no good. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Christie the pass to Sharp. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. Here's Mr. Moves. 6 points for him. And shot on the way. Good on the jump shot. Mr. Moves got 8 points.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter. And now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
So halt the run. Trills the three-pointer.
But the defense not doing a good job at all of getting after him. They've got to crowd him and make it tough for him. That's his second this quarter.
Here is Bonner.
He pulls off the Houdini to make that catch and slam it through.
Stupendous alley-oop.
And the crowd got their jaws dropped on that one. Total disbelief.
1:27 left in the first half. Buries it from three-point range.
Timeout.
12 points for the Cobra.
And this is the game plan for him. He's a big part of their floor spacing.
And you know what? It's all about the long-distance game for him tonight. He's getting it done from out there.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
With some changes. Lewis checked in for Christie, and the professor subbed in for Bonner. 1:24 left in the first half. Here's Mr. Moves. 10 points for him. Knocked loose. Here's Smooth. Pass to Tavares. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. And Lewis has it in the corner. Buries the long-range jumper. Lewis has got nine.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
Now, here's Marshall. He's still scoreless so far in this one. And it's blocked. And as it goes out of bounds, Omaha able to keep the ball here.
I had a chance to check out the stats for Smooth, how he performed last season. Second in free throw percentage, fifth in assists, and amongst the league's top-tier scorers, top 20 in points per game.
And back to his free throw shooting percentage, second in the league, I never saw lapses in his concentration at all. Always completely focused, completely automatic. Here's the quick. Passes it to Smooth, six to shoot. Fires from the wing. Lewis grabs the board. Los Angeles leading by 22. Here's the professor. And a miss there on the triple. For Omaha, they've gone 6 of 14 shooting here in the second. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. McKnight, the pass to Smooth. And Holmes now, top of the key. And again, no good by Omaha.
And that's a very low percentage shot. Not good basketball at all. One he probably should have passed on.
And so it's Los Angeles holding a 22-point lead as the quarter wraps up. Their defense has been terrific in this game. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thank you. Here with Brett Brown. Now, Coach, it seemed like you guys came out a little flat. How do you get some energy for the second half?
You just got to go with the people that have energy. I feel like we are not the aggressors. We have to do whatever we're going to do through our defense, and so far it's been poor.
Brett, thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, and we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Boy, what a crowd joining us here for our halftime report. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Kenny the Jet Smith and the Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal. And guys, for Los Angeles, Kenny, what's your take?
What a brilliant, unselfish half of basketball they just played. Their ball movement was absolutely impeccable. All in all, just beautiful basketball to watch.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the visiting team.
Well, there's no wonder they're getting blown out. No energy, no fight in the rebound battle. Ernie, you got to pick it up. You got to pick it up starting now, or it's going to be impossible to come back. Like the Pythagorean theorem, times 50, times 100, times 50, times 10. Impossible to figure out, Ernie.
And that's all we have for now. Tell the folks goodbye, Shaq. Tell the folks goodbye,
goodbye.
Kenny. Goodbye. Go to Kevin Harlan.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. Nice game. Great performance by the Cobra.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Williams is out there with the bulldozer. Then there's Shake and Bake. Then there's the Professor. And it's Christie in at the three. That's the group starting the second half for Quinn Snyder. Fangs home the trifecta. The Cobras got the first points of the third quarter up on the board for Omaha. Who is outside? The pass to Christie. Outside Williams. Here's the Professor. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. Williams has got three assists tonight. Clark, among the bigs, which one do you think runs the floor the best?
Boy, I tell you, Anthony Davis is gazelle-like, and this guy is north of 7 feet tall and is just agile and quick in getting up and down. I think I'd put him at the top of the list. Clint Capella is in that category, and Giannis Antetokounmpo as well, but a lot of times he has the ball and is taking it rack
yes,
to rack.
Yes, he does. Brings it up like a guard, and no one can stop him.
Nobody can stop him. Gets coming downhill at you.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Here's the Cobra. 18 points for him. Hands it from downtown.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Well, I think they're getting caught in that in-between zone, no man's land, giving up three straight from beyond the arc right now. Tough miss, especially since the defense wasn't that strong. I mean, he needs to cash in from there.
Pass to Smooth. The Cobra passes to Alvarez. The three, Marshall. Christie with the rebound. Los Angeles leading by 16. Here's the Professor. He's got 10. Kicks to Lewis. Passes it to the Bulldozer. It's up a three. Omaha with the rebound.
Far from an ideal start here. I mean, this half just 1 for 4 so far.
Here's Smooth. He clangs that one off the back iron, and down it falls.
Okay, nice job here in the second half. Field goal percentage is way up from what it was at halftime when it was just barely above 30%.
Now, here's Lewis. 9 points in the game so far.
They've been going to him an awful lot this game, and you can see why. He's pouring it on.
Omaha calls timeout.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
Yeah, you know, just look at the numbers, guys. I mean, they are being taken to the woodshed in the paint.
Deciding to change it up. Courtesy of the 2K leaderboard, here's a peek at the league's top scorers from a season ago. Well, you look at the Professor, leading the league in points per game. Such a great player. And, of course, the Cobra, right behind him. Another guy that's having a great scoring season.
And what an option either of those two guys give you. They're both excellent safety valves when an offense is struggling.
Here's Smooth. Turk drops in the tray. 5 points in the game.
You know, pretty much anybody can hit that shot when they're that wide open. I mean, terrible defense.
To the middle. They swipe it. Here's the Cobra. Lewis covering. Now the pass to Smooth. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
And after an abysmal first half from the field, the shot's now starting to fall.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And over the course of last year, he was up over 90%. And with a stroke like that, you see why.
Yeah, that's a great asset to have, guys, for any team. Coming down the stretch in close games, you've got a guy who's confident and very good at the line. When he steps up there, you feel good about it.
Clark, when you think of athleticism specifically, talk about the changes athletically we've seen in the league, say, since the 80s.
It's dramatically different. I mean, there have been tremendous athletes through every decade of the league's existence, but it's gotten better with improved training and more knowledge about the anatomy of the body and how to enhance its performance. But now it seems like great athletes are, you know, a dime a dozen versus 8 to a dozen back in the 80s.
And just tacks a few more points onto their lead with the tomahawk.
Ah, that's bringing it down hard.
Guys, it is symbolic of their effort here tonight.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Here's Smooth after the basket by Los Angeles.
And you know what? One of the few bright spots in this game for them today. He's kept his edge even though they've been trailing.
Bonner passes to Sharp. He kicks it to Bonner. Pass to the Professor. Lewis on the wing. A three ball. Omaha with the rebound.
Oh, man, you know he'd love to have that one over.
Here's Smooth. And Omaha, another three.
Seems like he can't miss right now, guys. I mean, completely in the zone this quarter.
Los Angeles leading by 10. Passes it to Sharp. 55 seconds left to play in the third. Here's the Professor. Score the bucket. He's made 5 so far, shooting a very clean 5 of 7.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Here's the Professor. 12 points for him. Here's the three. Good on the triple. The Professor's got 2 now from beyond the arc in the thirds for Los Angeles. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Here's Smooth. trying to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Here's the professor, 15 points in the game. Can't connect. And so it's Los Angeles. Their lead at 15 going into the break. They've had such great ball movement and shot selection, and it's led to a terrific field goal percentage. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. Coach Brett Brown with some words for his players.
Take everything you got to come up with balls so that we win this game. Right? Anything loose, any rebounds, guards, you got to rebound.
Demanding an all-out effort from his guys.
And Kevin, it's got to be a gang rebounding approach. Just like he was talking about, they need every board they can get.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. So for Omaha right now, we've got Shake and Bake, and it's McKnight in at the one spot. The Go Braves checked in for Omaha. And here is Omaha now. They trail by 18. Just five to shoot. McKnight, the pass to Holmes. From outside, off the mark.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
And here is Omaha now, after the basket by Los Angeles. Here's the Cobra, pass to Marshall, for the three, hits it from three-point range.
Kevin, he didn't hesitate that time. The D gave him a step, and he just pulled up and drained the three.
A few possessions into the fourth quarter, just over a minute played.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
McKnight, the pass to Holmes, down low, and a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, he his only concern right now is getting the points on the board, and I don't mean style points.
Hey, I thought there was some style there, guys. What are you guys looking at? I mean, it was still a pretty sweet, flavorful one-hand flush.
Here's Lewis. Omaha making their last shot. Nailed from three-point land.
And he's on his way to putting up a big three-point total.
Omaha calls timeout. Clark, you were so prolific in so many areas of the game. Which part of basketball came the easiest for you?
I think the rebounding piece. I always had a knack for sniffing out missed shots and had the size and timing and hands to chase down rebounds. But that was probably the strength of my game and the most unique part of it at an early age. And then the ball handling. My dad was 6'4 in the 50s, which meant you pretty much played inside. And he drummed into my head and my heart. Make sure you can handle that ball. So from the time I started playing, I was dribbling and making sure I could handle it, and it served me well during my playing career.
For the quick. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. And the basket is good. Got it to go through on the contact, so a free throw coming up. A great opportunity for a three-point play.
Win
And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for Los Angeles?
Fantastic passing. We saw it in the first half, and it's carried over here in the second.
They've really been on fire from beyond the arc tonight, too. I mean, a lot of their points have come from out there.
And that one misses. Los Angeles leading by 16. Lewis outside. Inside. The pass to the professor. Pocket six. Lewis down low. Here's the bulldozer. And the rejection by Holmes. Pass to Marshall. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Here's the Cobra. Ripped away and out of bounds as Omaha gains possession. Los Angeles making a switch here. Williams has checked in.
Williams.
Omaha trails by 16. Feeds it to Marshall. Omaha moving the ball around. Holmes down low. Makes it off the glass. Holmes got his first basket of the night.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
The steal. Fast break. Here we go. Here's Marshall. Oh, and the jam by Marshall.
Pressuring the ball and making a play that created the opportunity.
You know, you push it after a steal, there's almost no chance the defense can get back and recover.
Here's the professor. Score that one for him. His eighth field goal. 8 for 11 on a very accurate night.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
Now, here's Holmes. 4 on the shot clock. Lewis grabs the board.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
The bulldozer. Here's Williams. He's off on that one. And it's Omaha taking it the other way. There's the feed to Marshall. Here's the Cobra. To the paint. Here's Tavares. Lewis grabs the board.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Here's the professor. And again, Los Angeles with a triple.
Late in the game, up big, they continue to attack.
I don't think you want to get loose and sloppy or ease up, but it is time for them to start using that clock a bit.
Here's the Cobra. Pass to Marshall. Clark, here's kind of an interesting perspective question for you. How much of making it to the NBA is talent? How much of it is the work you put into it?
Kevin, if I were to give this a ratio, I would probably say 65% talent, 35% work ethic. Wow. Because you have to have a level of unique giftedness to be an NBA player. Many can work really hard and not be NBA caliber. So I think there's, I tilt that 65-35 talent to work ethic.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for Los Angeles.
Two great rebounding teams.
And these guys worked just a little bit harder tonight, and that was the edge they needed.
And during the long NBA season, each contest important here tonight. Tonight's win will give them 4 on the season. A very solid win indeed. And when you check out the box score, there were some great numbers for Shake and Bake.
Every time there was a big possession or a big play, he was a major contributor. Just a great all-around game.
Lydon's checked in for Williams. Here's Little General. Moore outside. Pass to Smith. Can they get it? A three-pointer is right on target.
And, you know, even though he's not a lights-out shooter from deep, the defense still has to be more aggressive there.
8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Hicks, covered by Smith. It's deflected. Hicks kicks to Wyden. Here's Hicks. So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. Some good moments throughout this one, but they have the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor, completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester, and that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. See you later.